drug buy bust, resisted arrest, three dead. It was one of those police operations where drug suspects allegedly refused to cooperate with arresting officers and got killed in the process. But an eyewitness who surfaced tells a different story. Police allegedly beat up the suspects before shooting them one by one.
Umiyak ng mama. Tulungan niyo ako, mama. Mama, mama. Nag-aaral ako, sir. Babaril mo sa ulo. Kita ko talaga, sumabog yung bungo ng bata. Pulala talaga ako.
Death certificates show the suspects suffered multiple gunshot wounds in the head and in different parts of the body. According to the witness, the police then staged the crime scene and placed guns on the suspects' hands.
Patay na yung mga tao, wala naman nangyaring barilan, encounter. Sila lang nakapapatok ng mga baril. Doon ko nakikita talaga na dramatized na lang ginawa nila.
Eh, wala nga pong baril yun. Kaliwete po yan.
The Navotas Police has not responded to our request for comment. 3 years into the war on drugs, the bloody pursuit of supposed drug offenders continues.
The illegal drugs war will not be sidelined.
Human rights groups assail the campaign as the number of deaths continues to rise.
Nakita namin nag-tone down sila, naging mas sophisticated, mas naging cautious. Pero hindi natin sasabihin na tumigil ang patayan kasi tuloy-tuloy pa rin.
Yung pagpatay, harap-harapan, usual na. Hindi yung iba pa, previously nakatago pa eh, discreet pa eh. Unlike ngayon, harap-harapan na eh. Sa harap ng pamilya mo, harap ng tao, tapos palabasin nila, shoot out sa report.
But police say the recent killing of a cop in Rodriguez Rizal is proof positive drug suspects are resisting arrest.
How many deaths of cops do we need to have to really prove our point na nanlalaban ang mga suspects, no? And we have a lot of us also got wounded in our all anti-illegal drugs operations.
The spokesperson of the Philippine National Police says the number of deaths are only a small portion out of the 240,000 drug suspects who surrendered. More than 100 policemen have been dismissed from service because of deaths during operations, including three cops convicted for the death of teenager Kian De Los Santos. He adds crime incidents have gone down. According to the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, it has seized 35 billion pesos worth of illegal drugs. But critics ask, where are the big-time drug personalities and why are the fatalities mostly poor?
Kasi ang mga leaders ng mga drug syndicate, hindi naman humahawak ng droga at hindi rin naman sila armado, no? So, ang ginagamit nila ay iyong network nila.
Alam nga nila, pag buy-bust operation talaga, non-bailable. So, manlaban ka na lang, at least may chance ka pang siguro makatakas o makaganti man lang sa mga law enforcers na nandun.
Authorities insist the government is winning the war against drugs. Surveys show the drug war enjoying high support from the public.
Well, if there's a score, a perfect score, I would rate it as a perfect score.
But it has also invited scrutiny from the international community. The International Criminal Court Office of the Prosecutor is still conducting a preliminary examination on the drug war in the country. Well, just last week, the United Nations Human Rights Council voted to look into the human rights situation in the Philippines.
They don't understand the social, economic, political problems of the Philippines.
For Peter, the only thing he wants to hear from President Duterte in the coming State of the Nation address is the promise to go after drug lords and to stop police abuses.
Dapat mapigil na yung ganyan, karahasan. Wala nga tayong silbi ng elektriya, wala tayong bitay eh. Bakit kinakailang patayin ng tao? Kung narin ako ng Presidente Duterte, ayusin mo disiplina ng polis. Pag may disiplina ng polis, may disiplina mamamayan, uulad ng Pilipinas.
Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.